What's up, lads? Josh here, and welcome back to another squad builder. And this squad builder is going to be a 2013 summer transfer BPL squad. And hopefully you guys are going to enjoy this because I kind of do want to do a different squad as well. I want to do different leagues of these summer transfers because, you know, summer transfers is quite a big, big thing for football. You got a lot of big names like Cavani going to PSG, Jovetic to City recently. Who else? Gomez to Fiorentina. And I'm just thinking I might want to cover a lot of these transfers and just talk a little bit about them and do a squad builder around them. So hopefully you guys are going to look forward to seeing more of this because, you know, if this hits 300 likes, I definitely will be doing a few more of these because I really did enjoy doing, just a little bit of a different squad builder for you guys. But guys, if you're looking to buy or sell any FIFA 13 Ultimate Team coins, check the link in the description for the FIFA Shop. Fantastic little website for you to buy or sell some coins. £9 per 100k if you use the discount code Josh10. That link's in the description. So now let's get straight onto the squad builder. The goalkeeper that is going to start off this team, and it is going to be Steklenberg, transferred from Roma to Fulham, and he is looking very good. But it's, you know, he was actually an undisclosed fee, and I, you know, that obviously means, you know, they don't want to know, they don't want to tell people how much he cost. So it's just undisclosed at the moment. But he has 86 diving, 79 handling, 80 kicking, 83 reflex, 34 speed, and 80 positioning. 6'6" tall, 4-star weak foot, 2,500 coins for a transferred goalkeeper with those sort of stats, I think is very cheap, and he's just a fantastic goalkeeper. The first centre-back to go into the team is going to be Diakite from Sunderland, who recently transferred from Lazio, and he was actually free, and that is a fantastic signing in my opinion. You know, he's a very, very strong centre-back in real life and a strong centre-back in the game, so for Sunderland to pick him up for free, I think is an absolutely amazing bargain, and he is just awesome. 70 pace, 79 defending, 85 heading, 6'4" tall, 1,600 coins for him. He is just a great centre-back. And now the left centre-back to go into the team is going to be a Liverpool player, and it is going to be, I've just gone past him, I'm pretty sure you'll have seen him though, it is going to be Kolo Touré, signed from Man City, and he also was a free transfer, which I didn't know. I thought that's Kolo Touré, I don't think they'd let him go for free, but apparently they have. 68 pace, 80 defending, 81 heading, and a free transfer from City to Liverpool is a very, very good signing for Liverpool, I'd say. 6 foot tall, 750 coins for him. He was just a decent centre back, a little bit slow on FIFA of course, but in real life he's just fantastic, and Liverpool will probably have a great season with him. The left back is going into the team, has returned from loan from QPR, and of course it is going to be Fabio from Manchester United. Was on loan from QPR and now he is back on Man United's side. 80 pace, 74 passing, 77 dribbling, 74 defending, and he is just a decent left back. 5'8" tall, 4-star for 3-star skill moves, and 750 coins for him. So now let's go on to the right back, and it is going to be a silver right back, and it is going to be he's actually transferred, he was on loan from Vitesse, I think, in Eredivisie, was a centre back, and now he is a right back for Chelsea. But he is a fantastic player. I loved him when I used him at centre back. I still actually have him in a team, I'm using him in a team right now, and he is just awesome. So I've got him in the right back position for this squad, and he's actually a very good player. 80 pace, 33 defending, and 74 heading. 6 foot tall, 3-star weak foot, 2-star skill moves, 4,000 coins. Is quite expensive, but honestly, I think he's well worth it with those sort of stats. You know, I can't wait to see more from him next year if he does actually play for Chelsea, or he'll probably just get loaned out again, I'm not too sure. But he was a fantastic player to use. And now the next centre mid to go into the team, the first centre mid is going to be Essien, returning from Real Madrid on loan. I think, I didn't actually know Essien was on loan to Real Madrid. I thought, they'd signed him, but apparently it was just on loan. And of course, he has now returned. 66 pace, 674 shooting, 82 passing, 76 dribbling, 82 defending, and 76 heading. 5'10" tall, 4-star weak foot, 3-star skill moves, 2,600 coins. And the goal he scored was absolutely sublime. It was like a 32-yard or 34-yard. Just a long shot, and it just sailed over the goalkeeper. Really, really nice goal that I scored with him. And he goes straight into the squad. Now the silver centre mid to go into the team is going to be another Chelsea player. I've used him in a team before, and it is going to be Josh McEachran. 76 pace, 63 shooting, 76 passing, 76 dribbling, 59 defending, and 50 heading. And of course, he is he's actually returned on loan from Chelsea to Middlesbrough. From Middlesbrough to Chelsea. He is now back at Chelsea. And he, you know, he's probably just going to get loaned out again because I think he's quite young, 1993. So there you go, he's like 19, 20 years old. So he's quite young, and he'll probably just get loaned out again. I can't see him playing in like the main 11 for a while. But hopefully, he should be a cool player for Chelsea in the upcoming years. And now the next sentiment to go into the team is going to be a Spurs player, and it is going to be Paulinho. And he did of course sign from Corinthians from Spurs, and that cost him, you know, Spurs had to pay 17 million coins, 17 million pounds for Paulinho from Corinthians, and that is a large amount of money for a guy that's only just come out recently, you know, like in the last 2 or 3 years, people have started knowing his name, but he is now a fantastic player in real life, of course, and on the game. 80 pace, 71 shooting, 74 passing, 78 dribbling, 77 defending, and 73 heading. 5'11" tall, freestyle weak foot, freestyle gomers. 5,000 coins is expensive for a non-rare player, but he is a fantastic one at that, and he's normally a CDM as well, so for picking him up for 5,000 in CM is very cheap in my opinion. So now let's go into the right forward, and that is going to be, of course, Jesus Navas, signed from Sevilla to Man City for 14.9 million. And, you know, as I said, Paulinho cost 17 million, and now City picked up Jesus Navas for 14. So he picked him up for 3 mil cheaper, and I personally do believe Jesus Navas is a much better player than Paulinho, you know, not being biased or anything. Just from what I've seen from Jesus Navas, he is much, much better player than Paulinho. But, of course, you know, one's a midfielder, and one is an attacking attacker or, you know, attacking midfielder, etc., or winger, whatever you want to, you know, title Jesus Navas as. He is still a very, very good player. 92 pace, 33 shooting, 80 passing, 86 dribbling, and 57 heading. 5'7" tall, 3-star weak foot, 4-star skill moves, 83,000 coins, and scored 4 goals in 5 games. I thought that was a fantastic little record for him, and can't wait to see him in the BPL for Man City. I can imagine a lot of probably informs, probably like 1 or 2 informs, if he has a good season, which I can imagine he will do. And now going on to the left forward, it is going to be Schürrle, who I've used in a hybrid before, and it is going to be, you know, like I said, Schürrle. He signed from Bayer Leverkusen to Chelsea for 18 million. So, you know, even four million more than Jesus Navas. So lots of money being, you know, being just squandered here on players that, you know, they're known, but they're not as well known as like Jesus Navas or Paulinho. But, you know, Schürrle is a good signing, I guess, but 18 million is a lot of money for a player. And you know, seems though, like, how much is Rooney nowadays? Like, somebody offered him like 18 million or 20 million, and I think he's much better than Schürrle in my opinion, without being biased or out. But now going on to the striker that's going to complete this team, and it is going to be, when we get over to it, it is going to be the Everton striker. It is going to be Kone, who I didn't actually know signed from Wigan, and it was a undisclosed fee, so we don't even know how much he signed for. But he is going to be a great signing because he played so well for Wigan this season, scoring a lot of goals and just, you know, constantly helping out his team. Unfortunately, Wigan did get relegated, and now he's moved to Everton, so Everton should have a great and strong team for next year. 87 pace, 73 shooting, 78 dribbling, and 76 heading on him. He's just awesome. 6 foot tall, 4-star weak foot, 4-star skill moves, 1,700 coins. Only scored 1 goal in 5 games, which kind of sucks, but, you know, he played really well indeed. And I did enjoy using this team, and guys, if you did enjoy it, leave a like rating. 300 likes would be awesome, and if we do hit 300 likes, guys, I'm going to do another league, and, you know, hopefully you guys did enjoy it. If I did miss any, you know, if I did miss any players that, of course, that are, you know, transferred, I will definitely do another BPL squad for the 2013 summer transfer. So hopefully you did enjoy it. Leave a like rating if you did. Subscribe to my channel if you're new around here. Apart from that, guys, I'll see you guys soon. See you later.
Walk, little walk, small talk, big thoughts, gonna tell them all just what I want. That street, two streets, I see you and me hanging on the empty swings. Count high, low, don't worry, my eyes are closed, I'm the Superman and it's my show. One shoe, two, gonna kick with my new shoes, I'm gonna kick until I need new shoes.
Have those hipsters, I wanna dance.
I said it, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop talking to me. Stop.